So let's see the Fremo pump. Fremo is a submersible. It is submerged in the cargo tank. Deep well, submerged in the deep cargo tank. Centrifugal pump, centrifugal operated by centrifugal force, the centrifugal by an impeller, which we have seen the centrifugal pumps. So deep well submersible cargo pumps used on made by Fremo company is used in the chemical tankers. Mostly all the chemical tankers have a separate pump for each tank, and also in gas tankers also we have, or sometimes in product tankers also. So it is a very efficient high discharge capacity pump, and it is, all the new regulations are covered in this. Like we have for next two chemicals, we require to strip up to 75 liters maximum in the cargo tank. So this pump is very efficient and almost the best for this type of operations. So let's see the main parts. We know we have an impeller and volute casing for all the centrifugal pumps. And then we have the discharge line, the cargo discharge line with the cargo discharge valve. And here we have a small stripping line also for stripping the last part of the cargo. So how we are doing is stripping is when the last part of cargo is left, we decrease the pump RPM from between 60 to 100. And then generally it is operating at 120, 180 to 200 RPM. And that is for full discharge rate, and for stripping we decrease to less than 100, and then the cargo is going into the stripping line, and finally in the discharging line, and finally when the cargo is almost last part of the cargo is there, we do stripping. So for stripping we close the discharge valve and put the air, compressed air or nitrogen, into the, we push this, the pump is operating, the cargo is collected in the discharge line, and with the air the cargo is pushed from the pump and it goes into the stripping line. We open the stripping valve and the cargo goes into the discharge line. So to move this impeller we have this hydraulic motor here, and this hydraulic motor is rotating the shaft, and the shaft is rotating the impeller. This hydraulic motor is moved by the hydraulic pipes, the high pressure pipe, the inlet pipe, and the outlet pipe, low pressure pipe. So this cargo which is discharged should not go into the system. So we have a cargo seal here for that. And this oil, hydraulic oil, which is moving the hydraulic motor, should not come into the system or cofferdam. This blue part is the cofferdam or the empty space. So oil should not come here, and the cargo also is not leaking, it should not come here. To check that and to mark that, we have a cargo seal to avoid ceramic, made of ceramic material. The cargo seal avoids the cargo to go into the cofferdam, and the oil seal avoids the oil to come into the cofferdam and mix and contaminate. So we have a cofferdam space, it's empty space. It is empty space all throughout the pump. This is a cofferdam pipe, and this is a cofferdam space. So if cargo is, seal is leaking, we will see, we can find from the cofferdam, and if oil seal is leaking, we'll find from the cofferdam. So how to find? In the cofferdam pipe, there is a cofferdam purging place. We attach the air again from the deck nitrogen or compressed air, and we put the air into this, and whatever is collected here, any cargo or oil leak, it will go into the cofferdam check pipe. This is a cofferdam check pipe, and it will be collected in the exhaust trap. So this is the line exhaust that air is coming mixed with the leaked cargo and oil into this here trap, and it will be collected here. So we have this trap so that, because it will keep pushing, and whatever initially it will be very small droplets normally if it is not leaking much. So all whatever droplets slowly slowly it will keep coming and collected here, and when we open this wall we put a bucket and we can collect and see how much oil or cargo is leaking. So we have seen the impeller, volute casing, cargo seal, mechanical seal, hydraulic motor, hydraulic oil return and inlet pipe, discharge valve, stripping line, then the deck mountings for fitting the cargo pump in the tank, the deck trunk and resilient mountings or the top plates. Then for operating the pump, we have the speed torque control valve to control the torque of the force of the motor or the pump. And we have a local control valve. Local control valve is to adjust the RPM of the pump, and that we are using this local control valve to control the pump locally when we are doing stripping or tank cleaning. Then we have the suction well, the mouth of the pump from where the cargo is entering the impeller or the volute casing. Then we have the anti-rotation brakes, so that the pump, this shaft is not rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, and all the parts we have seen. Now let's see in detail the parts of Fremo. So this is in detail. You can see the suction funnel from which the cargo will go. This suction funnel has to be connected to the impeller, but in between they should not damage each other while rotating. So we have a wear ring to prevent the rotational and frictional damage, and they are connected with the bolts and brackets. Then we have a locking ring to lock the suction funnel to the suction cover, and then it is connected to the impeller. The impeller is connected to the casing by the O-ring and Fremo seal element, so that they are not leaking. Then wear ring to avoid the wear and tear, and the support for the wear ring to keep it in place. And perforated plates acting like a packing, then nut bolts, and then the volute casing. Then for the seal, we have, you can see here, this is the red spring seal, the sensitive lips of the seal, double lip seal, assembling cylinder. So this is the cylinder in which you have the shaft, and you have the double lip seal here, and the seal housing, and the sleeve retainer bolts. This is the sleeve and this is the shaft, and then here we have the double lip seal. Then you have the supporting rings and rings. So let's see in details. These are all the parts of your lip seal arrangement. So we saw the impeller, up to the impeller volute casing, which is connected to the impeller hub, the top of connected to the shaft. And then we have again the O-rings and Fremo seal ring. Then we have a seal ring housing, the housing to for the seal ring. Then we have the double lip seal. Then all the supporting rings and supporting washers. Then we have a single lip seal. Then we have a sleeve retainer to keep the sleeve retained. Then we have the ceramic sleeve. The cargo seal is also made up of ceramic materials, which is compatible with the cargo. The ceramic sleeve to keep the shaft in place and avoid vibrations. And then we have the main parts, you can see here. So we saw the impeller and the volute casing and the wear rings to keep to avoid the wearing of this impeller and volute casing. Then we have the cofferdam. We have the cargo seals here. The cargo seals, you can see, is fitted here so that the cargo is not going here. It's not leaking. Then we have the mechanical oil seal here so that the oil is not coming here. Then we have the roller bearings to keep rotating the shaft without friction. Then with the backstop unit or anti-rotating unit brakes, then the ball bearings for good movement of the shaft. Then hydraulic motor and cofferdam and the hydraulic oil return and inlet pipe, pressure pipe. And this is the main frame of pump. So now let's see the working of the frame of pump. So before operating the frame of pump for maintenance, we have to lock the hydraulic pipe inlet and lock it so that by mistake nobody opens this. And then we have to purge the cofferdam to see there is no dangerous cargo or any leak into the system. Then we start, we keep all the standard Fremo toolboxes there, keep them ready. And of course, enclosed phase entry procedure and everything has to be followed. And we have to go through the instruction manual for maintenance and repair for the Fremo pump. So let's see how we are dismantling the Fremo pump and the parts of it. So first, we are dismantling of impeller and wear rings. Normal service is done by the crew on board. Only can also can do this. So we take out the main cover and secure it and take out all the loose, all the nut bolts and then turn the impeller clockwise with the Allen keys, remove the Allen bolts and take out. And then we can remove the nuts from the main pipe, the impeller bolts, impeller supporting bolts. And when all these are disconnected, we can remove the impellers without damaging them. So to avoid that damage, we keep this Teflon tray because impellers and this thing should not get damaged or in contact with the bilge well. And slide them slowly out so that they are not getting damaged. It's a very sensitive material. Now, this is the wear ring you saw and the wearing locking ring also. Then we have the seals, double lip seal and the O-rings. So we reverse the direction of the volute casing and we take out the other wearing and the suction funnel from down. And then we open the other parts of the impeller. So suction funnel cover is removed and then this is the impeller and the volute casing. This is the impeller, you can see it's clean. Now we will go to see the sequence number two. To remove the cargo lip seal of the cofferdam. So we remove the pipes connected, cofferdam pipe and all. And we have the special tools to remove this, given in the Fremo tools, to remove this So now we can remove the ceramic seal by this tool. We keep the thing supported. This is the housing, seal housing. And we remove this, and you can see this is the ceramic seal, this is the cargo seal, and the retainer ring for the ceramic seal. So this is the cargo seal. If it is damaged, the cargo will leak into the buffer dam. Then we remove the sleeve. This is a ceramic sleeve to keep supporting the shaft. Now the draining of the pump, we have the mechanical seal. So we open the hydraulic system and increase the pressure. We release all the oil, we'll take out all the oil from the system. And then we have to dismantle the oil seal or other remaining rotating parts in the cargo pump heavy maintenance. So because we have to remove hydraulic oil seal, so all the main other parts, rotating parts, have to be removed and everything has to be done. So this is the double lip seal of oil seal, hydraulic oil seal, and the tools used are given in your, as per the manuals, this ship is provided. So these are the tools for removing the your seal. So the bearing housing is lifted up and this is the seal. And then it is lowered to keep, get the seal out and clean it. All these tools will be provided in your Framo toolkit. And then we dismantled all other parts for overhauling. Then we have sequence number 5. We will assemble all of them. So the main O-rings and things which need to be placed, we'll apply Araldite so that they remain in place. And so all screws are tightened up to the required pressure properly, and all seals are cleaned properly. This is the double lip seal and O-rings. So these are all the parts which we saw. And maximum run out for ceramic sleeve and impeller flange 0.03 and 0.05. Okay.